What's the best way of keeping your plant leaves clean or shiny, healthy and pest-free to help them thrive and bring life to your home? Welcome to the world of indoor plants. Hello, it's Nora the Lekker Queen, and I'm going to show you four simple ways of keeping your leaves clean and pest-free. The four methods I will show you rank from easiest, which is the least effective for pest control, to more involved, which is the one that's more effective for keeping pests at bay. So keep watching and find out how I keep my indoor jungle shiny and pest-free. How to clean indoor plant leaves. And while you're watching, don't forget to let me know what leaf cleaning methods you use in the comments below, because it's always nice to find out what other people are doing, because you never know, it might help me or someone else. Method number one is cleaning your plants as part of the watering process. So whether you're growing your plants in soil or growing your plants in semi-hydroponics, this is something that is very easy to do. Take your plant to the sink and give the leaves a wash and water at the same time. If you're growing your plants in semi-hydro, give the leaves a wash at the same time you're giving your plants a flush. You might need to use a shower head for plants with multiple small leaves like Hoyas to clean them all at the same time. You can dry the leaves with a microfiber cloth or with a microfiber glove, or you can just allow them to air dry. Check in the description below for the link to a free guide that I've created on how to clean your indoor plant leaves. Number two is using a paintbrush or a duster for plants that have got much, much larger leaves, or plants with really, really tiny leaves that don't necessarily like to have water on their leaves like African violets. Or at least that's what people say. In my experience, I've never found that my African violets have any problem when they have water on them, but hey, you might want to use a brush if you want to be careful. So the smaller and more delicate the plant, you want to use a softer and smaller brush, just making sure you're not damaging the leaves as you're brushing. Item number three is my pest control spray. I'll let you know what's in this spray a little bit later. I give my plants a light spray. I'll grab a microfiber cloth, grab my plant leaf, and just wipe that spray down. And that gives it a lovely sheen, and my plants just look absolutely fantastic. Using this spray in this way doesn't do much for pest control. All it does really is just leave that peppermint spray, which I think is absolutely lovely, that pests absolutely hate. Peppermint oil works really well at preventing pest infestations. Its scent highly irritates insects like spider mites, and they prefer to stay away from plants that have got the peppermint oil scent, which works really, really well for all of us. So when I'm using method number three, it's really just to get the plant looking nice and clean. It's not really for pest control. Method number four, however, is the real deal. That's what's going to keep your plants clean and completely pest-free. If you're finding value from this video, please give it a like and subscribe to my channel. Having plants look amazing is a great reason to clean the leaves, but more importantly, clean and dust-free leaves are crucial for plant health. Dust and debris on the plant leaves can actually clog the pores on the plant leaves, which interfere with the plant's photosynthesis and respiration, meaning that dirty leaves actually cause your plants to starve and suffocate at the same time. So method number four requires use of my pest control spray. I spray it on my plants and let them air dry with the spray on. I like to do this at night because the neem oil makes the plant leaves sensitive to light, and they could burn if exposed to grow light or very strong sunlight. So I find nighttime treatment to be the best. Leave it on and let the pests consume the neem oil and they will die. To make the pest control, I use water, 100% neem oil, peppermint essential oil, and Dr. Bronner peppermint soap. I mix 1.5 teaspoons of the neem oil concentrate with 1 teaspoon of mild liquid soap and 1 liter of room temperature water, which is about 0.26 gallons. I put all of the ingredients into a spray bottle and shake it well. If this is your first time using this solution on your plant, just test it on one small leaf, let it sit for a few hours and see how that goes. If the plant tolerates it, then you can spray the whole plant. Spray the plant with your neem oil spray, making sure you're spraying the front and the back of the leaves and every part of the plant that you can. Keep the plant out of direct sunlight or grow light until the leaves are dry. I like to use my pest control spray every week on my plants, whether I see bugs or not. I use it as a deterrent, and like I said, it helps to clean the leaves of my plant. The leaf care and pest control routine that I recommend is a combination of the four methods, really. So every time I take my plants for watering or for flushing, I wash off the leaves. And that takes all the dust off or any muck that's on there. And I do this however many times I flush my plant. I spray my plants with my pest control and leave it on the plants at least once a week. I do this at night to make sure I'm protecting my leaves. And on the days when I'm taking pictures of my plants, I use my spray, spray my plant leaves, wipe that down with a microfiber cloth, and my plant looks absolutely camera ready and it's ready for its close-up. Remember to download the free leaf care guides that I've linked in the description below. There's absolutely nothing like a plant with gorgeous big leaves. Watch this next video where I show you how I get my plants to achieve these big leaves. You too can have these big leaves to shine to your heart's content. I'll see you there.